You think the upcoming election would in any way change the political situation in Thailand?
I think it will change. And I think it will happen this year. The most likely date now is 24th of March. I think it will change the landscape of Thai politics in many sense, because we see that now there are many emerging political parties with new different ideologies. And with the fact that we see from the past, the junta never successfully, you know, manage the election and win the election successfully. So we will, even though many people said that after the election, we will not have the stable democracy yet, but at the same time, we will not see a stronger authoritarianism as well.
What are the key actors, if you look at the election this time, you know, whom we have to pay, you know, special attention? You think that member of the coup would also play a role here? And then with the possibility of Khun Prayut coming back as Prime Minister, what about Thaksin, Shinawat Party, and also other emerging political party? What do you think, who in particular we should, you know, pay attention?
So I think the there will be three main parties in three different political polls. One is, of course, Thaksin factions, Thaksin allies parties, which now they split parties into Thai Raksa Chat and Pheu Thai. They will still dominate in the north and the northeast, and I think they will do quite well even with a new electoral system that try to hurt them. Okay, but they will still be forced to reckon with. The second group is, of course, the Palang Pracharat Party, the nominee party backed by the junta. I think it's clear that this is a proxy party for the military in order to help Prayut return as a prime minister. I think for the NCPO and Prayut, the stake of this election is high, very, very high. They cannot afford to lose this election. Otherwise, it's gonna be a wasted coup for them, right? They spend a lot of resource and time in the past 4 years. They cannot fail this election. And clearly, Prayut want to return as a prime minister. So we will see the NCPO and Prayut use all state apparatus to intervene in the electoral process to help Palang Pracharat to win election. So it will not be a free and fair election. The last group that still play important role is Democrat Party of Abhisit Vechachiwa to have a stable government led by Palang Pracharat and Prayut. They still need Democrat Party to join the coalition government.
So you said elsewhere that even the old power faction continue to consolidate the power, and especially we can see now through the writing of the constitution that would, you know, be so beneficial to them. Can you just explain a little bit, you know, what kind of tactic that they have been using, you know, in order to, for them, you know, to win the upcoming election?
So first of all, they decide the new electoral system, which is the system that no other countries in the world using at the moment. And with this new electoral system, it will hurt two major parties, Pheu Thai and Democrat. It will help the medium-sized party like Palang Pracharat to get more seat, and also party like Phum Chai Thai, Cha Thai, that will join the coalition government. So that one thing that they do. Second of all is the electoral boundary. So it's the first time that Thailand witnessed the so-called gerrymandering. We never have this kind of problem before, that we create the boundary of the election district to help one party in particular. So this time we witnessed this. And other trivial issues like, you know, the election ballot, okay, and the way that they ban the use of some photo figures like Thaksin, Yingluck, and Chuan in the poster campaign. So all of these tactics they do in order to decrease the popularity of their rivals.
Very briefly, can you tell us what would be a kind of scenarios that we should you know, expect after the election?
So it's likely that Prajak can return as a prime minister, but he will lead a very weak coalition government. And with this weak coalition government, it can lead to instability. And I don't think Prajak government after the election can finish their full year's term. So basically, we will lead to more instability and also unpredictability after the election.
Last question, putting the Thai election in the regional context, you said elsewhere too that, you know, Thailand would be in between, you know, not really the Malay model, you know, when the opposition party kind of won landslide election, or the Cambodian model when, you know, when the ruling party continue to be dominant in politics. How should we look at the Thai case, you know, from a regional perspective?
Thai case is quite a strange case that. So now we the only formal military government in the region. Who would think that in the 21st century Thailand would end up like this military government, the only country in the region. So that one thing. The second thing is the lesson to other countries is in order to have a stable democracy, you need a democratic force that fight for a long-term consolidation of democracy. And that has not yet to happen in Thailand. But the Thai style authoritarianism or the Thai model that somewhere between Malaysian and Cambodian model, I think is a dangerous model. At least Cambodian, you have some sort of political order. Malaysian model, you have democratization. In Thailand, we have the worst of both worlds. No democracy, at the same time, no political order. No political stability.
Thank you very much, Kap.